Hey folks, welcome to Digimento Education. This is Electronic Devices and Circuits Lecture 7. So I believe that you must have gone through all the lectures before that I covered before. Okay, so I request everyone to subscribe to our channel, which is Digimento, so that you never miss out any latest update. And press the bell icon so that you will be notified when a new video is uploaded, so that you never miss out any update. So I believe that you must have gone through all the lectures before. Let's start with the first topic of discussion in this lecture. So first one we are going to discuss is the law of electrical neutrality. Electrical neutrality. So law of electrical neutrality is applicable to all the semiconductors. So what does it say? So law of electrical neutrality says that it is based on the conservation of charge. It is based on the conservation of charge. So it says that for any extrinsic semiconductor, total positive charge is equal to total negative charge. Okay, so you have Nd plus P is equal to Na plus N. This relationship is applicable to all the extrinsic semiconductors. Okay, Nd is the donor concentration, Na is basically the acceptor carry concentration. Okay, so for intrinsic semiconductor, there is no doping, so Nd is equal to Na is equal to 0, which implies that P is equal to N. It is in pure state. Okay, so, and it's important to note down that all semiconductors are neutral because of law of electrical neutrality. We cannot say that N-type semiconductor is negatively charged. We cannot say P-type semiconductor is positively charged. We cannot say anything beyond this. Okay, so every semiconductor is neutral. So N-type and P-type semiconductors are neutral. Okay, now let's move on to some derivations so that you get a very finite departure from the theoretical concept that we have been that I have been continuously telling you in the past few lectures. So derivations will make you feel happy. So now in this case, calculation of electron and hole concentration in extrinsic semiconductor. Okay, so this is the calculation of electrons and holes in the extrinsic semiconductor. Now first case, when doping concentration is very very greater than Ni, which is 10 times Ni, greater than 10 times Ni, then for N-type semiconductor, when doping concentration is greater, very very greater than Ni, which is minimum 10 Ni, so we can say that Nd is greater than Ni, so Nd is greater than 10 Ni, which I have specified, so we can say the electron concentration is equal to Nd, and the hole concentration in the semiconductor will be equal to Ni square divided by Nd, or Ni square by Nn. Okay, and the doping concentration is far greater than Ni, intrinsic carrier concentration, then this is the case. Okay, in the second case, this is for P-type semiconductor, so we can say from here that for the p-type semiconductor, your Na is greater than Ni, which means that Na is greater than 10 Ni. So we can say that Np will be equal to Ni square by Na. Okay, these two relationships are applicable when the doping concentration is far greater than the intrinsic carrier concentration. Okay, now let's say doping concentration is not that heavy. Okay, so let's take another case when doping concentration is comparable to Ni. Okay, so for n-type semiconductor, Nd is very close to Ni. So using the law of electrical neutrality, we can say Nd plus P is basically equal to Na plus N. Okay, and this is basically for we're considering the n-type semiconductor. So since for an n-type semiconductor, Na will be equal to 0, so Nd plus P will be equal to N. We cannot neglect the whole concentration here because Nd is comparable to Ni. Okay, so we can write Nd is, this is approximated, Nd plus P is equal to N is approximated to Nd equal to N only when doping concentration is very very high. Okay, so since it is comparable to Ni, we cannot neglect the whole concentration because it is comparable. We can write Ps Ni square divided by, now here we will not write Nd because we have not approximated the electron concentration to Nd. Okay, we have to write N here. Let me demarcate as N for an n-type semiconductor. So Nd is equal to Ni square by Nn is equal to Nn. Okay, so from here we get Nd into Nn plus Ni square is equal to Nn square. Okay, on solving this we get Nn is equal to Nd by 2 plus square root of Nd by 2 whole square plus Ni square. So this is basically the relationship. Okay, it is important to note down that this is only applicable when the doping concentration is less than 10 I, or okay, when it is comparable to Ni, when it is comparable to Ni. So it's equal to square root of Ni square. And your PN whole concentration will be equal to Ni square by Nn, not Ni square by Nd. No, we will not use this thing. It is correct. Okay, if it is comparable, otherwise you might end up getting the wrong results, which is not correct. Okay, so it is important to note down. Now let's move on to the next. So we will approximate that with this thing only when Ni is when Nd is far greater than Ni. Okay, so second is for the p-type semiconductor. So for p-type semiconductor, okay, so again following the law of electrical neutrality, Nd plus P is equal to Na plus N, related to PP. So Nd will be equal to 0 in this case. We will solve PP will be equal to Na plus Ni square by PP. Similarly, you will get the whole concentration PP as Na by 2 plus square root of Na by 2 whole square plus Ni square. Okay, by following the same procedure you end up getting this result. Okay, when Na is far greater than Ni, we can neglect Ni from this square root expression, and this will reduce to Na by 2, and Na by 2 plus Na by 2 will be equal to Na. That's a approximation we made in the first case. Okay, so if you need to find out the electron concentration, the p-type semiconductor will be equal to ni square by pp, okay, not na, ni square by na. No, you do not have to use this thing. So these are the two important results that you should know. Okay, now let's discuss an example based on this. So let me try to explain in each and every, this is a question. Okay, so it says the pure semiconductor is doped with the donor concentration impurities with 20^7. This is a ratio of doping ratio. Calculate. So now first it asks calculation of the asked to find out the donor concentration. So we know this thing, that donor concentration is the number of atoms per centimeter cubed into impurity ratio. So number of atoms we are available with is 4.421. So 4.421 into 10 to the power 22 into 1 divided by 10 to the power 7 per centimeter cube. This comes out 4.421 into 10 to the power 15 atoms per centimeter cube. So this is the doping concentration. B is electron and hole concentration, the doped semiconductor. Now from here we know this thing, that ND is 4.421 into 10 to the power 15. Okay, your NI is 2.5 into 10 to the power 13. So from here we can see that ND is greater than 10 times NI, or ND is far greater than NI. So we can directly use the relation ND is equal to N. Okay, 4.421 into 10 to the power 15. 10 to the power 15 per centimeter cube. So electron concentration, this is the electron concentration. Hole concentration will be equal to P is equal to Ni square by N, or ND will be equal to 2.5 into 10 to the power 13 whole square divided by 4.421 into 10 to the power 15. So answer would be 1.41 into 10 to the power 26 minus 15 give you 11 per centimeter cube. So this is the hole concentration and this is basically the electron concentration. Okay, now C part says to find the conductivity and resistivity of the semiconductor. Now conductivity of the semiconductor, since we can say that ND is greater than Ni, so conductivity we know this thing is N Q mu N plus P Q mu P. Okay, so from here it is clearly visible that ND concentration is far greater than the hole concentration. So this is negligible when we compare this with the electron concentration. So we can say, we can neglect this term, we can neglect this particular term and sigma N, in mainly due to NdQ mu N. Because even so, there is no harm in including this term and calculating the whole expression, but I just want to say that this will not have any effect. This will have a very 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 minute effect on the overall value. Okay, so we can, it is so small that we can easily neglect. So ND, you know, the ND is 4.421 into 10 to the power 15 into 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 into mu N. Mu N is electron concentration, 3800 centimeter square. Remember that they should be in the similar units. So it comes out to be 2.68 mu per centimeter. Do take care of the units. And resistivity will be equal to 1 by sigma N, will be equal to 1.2.68, will give you 0.373 ohm centimeter. Okay, this is the answer. Now let's move on to the D option, D question. What does it say? Let's have a look at that. how many times the conductivity is increased in semiconductor because of doping. So before that, we need to find out the intrinsic conductivity of the semiconductor so as to compare that with the conductivity after doping. So sigma I, again, that would be equal to when nothing is doped, NIQ mu n plus mu p, because for an intrinsic semiconductor, P is equal to N is equal to Ni. Okay, so Q is 1.6 to 10 power minus 19 into Ni. Ni in this case is 2.5 into 10 to the power 13, 3800 plus 1800. This comes out to be 0.0224 mo per centimeter, sigma I. Okay, so from here we can compare sigma n by sigma I. Sigma n we calculated is 2.68. So 2.68 divided by 0.0224 is nearly equal to 119.7, nearly equal to 120 times. Okay, 120 times. So from here we can make a note for 1 is to 10 to the power 7 doping, conductivity of germanium improves by 120 times. For 1 is to 10 to the power 8 doping, conductivity of germanium improves by 12 times. For 1 is to 10 to the power 6 doping, conductivity of germanium improves by 1200 times, and so on and so forth. Okay, it will go up to 1 is to 10 to the power 3. Okay, as we keep on increasing the doping, conductivity improves. Okay, conductivity improves because the charge carrier concentration increases. Okay, so this is how it is solved. You can basically try that particular formula which I just derived a couple of minutes ago by replacing the value by taking the value of ND comparable to Ni. So if you just take ND variable value comparable to Ni, you have to use the formula that I derived a couple of minutes ago. Okay, and then solve the same question again. Now let's move on to the next topic of discussion, is the minority carrier injection. So we're now going to discuss minority carrier injection. Okay, so what is the minority carrier injection? For example, we take a semiconductor. Let's say we take any semiconductor which is extrinsic semiconductor. We are now injecting the minority carrier in this. So for minority carriers, for let's say we take n-type sample, the minority carriers will be holes. We take p-type sample, the minority carriers will be electrons. The electrons, the concentration of the minority carriers will be maximum at the surface. Okay, the concentration of the minority carriers will be maximum at the surface. Okay, let's say we assume the concentration to be, let's say the concentration of the the minority charge carriers, I'm noting delta p for considering it's an n-type semiconductor by default. Okay, these minority charge carriers, since have the concentration, because of the concentration gradient, will diffuse through the length of the semiconductor. like this. So this is basically the diffusion profile of the minority charge carrier. So this is basically the diffusion profile. Okay, so this is basically the minority carriers. Okay, so it will be keep in mind this thing, that the concentration of minority carriers will be maximum at the surface, and then it will gradually diffuse through the length of the semiconductor. And okay, so concentration of minority carriers is maximum at the surface of the semiconductor. So concentration decreases through the length of the semiconductor, okay, by the means of diffusion. Okay, understood? So let's say for n-type semiconductor, we are considering that the holes are the minority carriers. So what will be the equation for this curve? So this curve is basically an exponential decay. So we can write it as delta t e to the power minus t by tau p, or delta p e to the power minus x by lp. So we can say that p of x for n-type semiconductor, p of x will be equal to delta p e to the power minus t by tau p, where tau p is basically the carrier lifetime, the minority carrier lifetime, it's basically function of time, so p of t, or p of x as delta p e to the power minus x by lp. Lp is diffusion length. And for the p-type semiconductor, minority carriers are electrons, so n of t will be delta n e to the power minus t by tau n, or n of x as delta of n e to the power minus x by ln. Understood? This is very much important. Okay, you will encounter multiple questions based on these formulas in the future examinations as well. Okay, understood? So when we consider that the carrier lifetime is infinity, let tau p is infinity, which means that the minority carriers are never going to incinerate. Okay, so what would happen to the equation? P of t is delta p e to the power minus t by infinity, and this will be equal to delta p. So it will never diffuse, the minority carriers will never diffuse. For example, this is n-type sample. So you are injecting the minority carriers, so the concentration is maximum at the surface, delta p. So it will remain constant for all the time. Okay, remain constant. It's never going to subside. Okay, so concentration remains constant forever. Okay. Okay, so let me take an example for this. Suppose you are given the whole concentration equation as 10 to the power 5 e to the power minus x by lp for x greater than or equal to 0. Okay, and let's say from here you can see that delta p is 10 to the power 5 per centimeter cube. Okay, which at the junction we can say delta p is 10 to the power 5 per centimeter cube. And LP from is given to us as 4.8 into 10 to the power minus 4 centimeter. Okay, and another thing is given that n of x is 6 into 10 to the power 14 e to the power minus mod x by ln. This is existing for x less than 0. Okay, so from here we can say 6 into 10 to the power 14 per centimeter cube, and ln is given to us as 9.6 into 10 to the power minus 4 centimeter. We are given with this information. Further information given to us is our dp 20 centimeters square per second. Dp is the whole diffusion constant, and electron diffusion constant is given to us as 35 centimeters square per second. Now the question asked is, now it is required to find out the value of diffusion current density at x is equal to 0 centimeter. So what is J? What is J diffusion at x is equal to 0 centimeter? So how can we do that? Let's try to solve this question. Okay, now let's first consider p of x. We can find out dpx by dx, because we know the diffusion current density equation consists of this particular term as so dp by dx. Now dp by dx will be equal to 10 to the power 5 minus 1 by lp minus 1 by lp e to the power minus x by lp. This has to be found at x is equal to 0. Okay, x is equal to 0, so this term will be equal to 1. So the answer comes out to be minus 10 to the power 5 upon lp. Lp is given to us as 4.8 into 10 to the power minus 4. Be careful with the units. Okay, so this comes out to be, on solving, you get it as minus 2.08 into 10 to the power 8 holes per centimeter cube per centimeter. Okay, holes per centimeter cube per centimeter, because it's dp by dx. Similarly, we can find out the concentration of electrons at the surface is 6 into 10 to the power 14 minus 1 by ln. Okay, where the x is equal to 0, that exponential term will be equal to 1, and this comes out, so 6 into 10 to the power 14 upon minus, along with minus, 9.6 into 10 to the power minus 4. The answer comes out to be minus 0.625 into 10 to the power 18 electrons per centimeter cube per centimeter. Okay, this is the two values that we have here. So current density at x is equal to 0, so Jn diffusion at x is equal to 0 will be equal to J diffusion at x equal to 0 will be equal to Jn diffusion at x is equal to 0 plus Jp diffusion at x is equal to 0. So this is basically Q dn dn by dx minus p, sorry again, this Q dp dp by dx. Okay, so this thing is equal to minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 into dn. Dn is equal to 35, and dp dn by dx at x is equal to 0 is minus 6.25 into 10 to the power 17, because here it is 0.625 into 10 to the power 18, so we write in terms of 17, minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 into dp. Dp is 20, and dp by dx is minus 2.08 into 10 to the power 8. You don't need to take care of the calculations here, because you are available with the calculators. You are given the virtual calculators in the gate examination, which you can use efficiently to solve such complex problems. Okay, you don't have to worry about the calculation part that you can easily do with the gate calculator, that the virtual calculator that you will be available with in the examination. So be through. So you should also go through each and every step that is involved in calculation using the gate calculator. On solving, the answer comes out to be 3.58 ampere per centimeter square. So this is J, overall diffusion current density at x is equal to 0. So if we have a look at the diagram, so the concentration of electrons is greater. Electrons are diffusing in the negative x direction. This is x less than 0, this is x greater than 0, and this is the hole concentration. Holes are diffusing like this, so holes and electrons. Okay, so this is basically 6 into 10 to the power 14, this is 10 to the power 5. Okay, so electrons, they are diffusing here, holes diffusing here. So hole current is in this direction, electron current is in this direction, total current is In plus Ip is equal to I is in this particular direction. Okay, hopefully this example is clear to you all. Okay, let's now discuss another topic, which is basically the compensated semiconductor. So far we have been discussing about n-type semiconductor and p-type semiconductor, in which only one type of doping is involved. Now suppose we dope an intrinsic semiconductor with two different type of dopants, like some concentration of pentavalent impurities and some concentration of trivalent impurities, then that type of semiconductor that we get is known as a compensated semiconductor. When we dope a semiconductor with electrons pentavalent and trivalent as well as the trivalent impurities, okay, that becomes a compensated semiconductor. Okay, so you should be clear with the definition of the compensated semiconductor. So when both donor and acceptor impurities are added, then the semiconductor obtained is a compensated semiconductor. Okay, or when donor impurities are added to the p-type semiconductor, or when acceptor impurities are added to the n-type semiconductor, they become compensated semiconductor. Okay, so either we add n-type and p-type dopants into intrinsic semiconductor, or we added the donor impurities in the p-type semiconductor, or when we add acceptor impurities in the n-type semiconductor, they all turn out to be a compensated semiconductor. Okay, when Na is equal to Nd, impurities are added into the intrinsic semiconductor. Now here, if Na is equal to Nd are added, equal number of electron and holes are there in the semiconductor still, so it is uncompensated. Understood? Or you can say it will still remain intrinsic. Because even if we add a greater amount of acceptor impurities into the intrinsic semiconductor, it becomes a p-type semiconductor. And when we add the same amount of d-type donor impurities, that will basically the electrons, the free electrons, the extra electrons will combine with the vacancies that were created due to the acceptor impurities, and this will compensate the presence of holes. Then again, it will become an uncompensated semiconductor, or intrinsic semiconductor will remain intrinsic. Okay, when ND is greater than NA, electrons are greater than the holes in the semiconductor, then semiconductor is N-type compensated. It is N-type compensated. And when NA is less than ND, it is a P-type compensated. Okay. So now let's have a look at some of the cases when for N-type composite semiconductor, when ND is greater than NA. When ND is greater than NA and ND minus NA is very, very greater than NI, intrinsic carrier concentration, then we can directly say the electron concentration in the N-type semiconductor is equal to ND minus NA. Understood? Because the hole concentration will be negligible, and we can say that NN is equal to ND minus NA, and the hole concentration is equal to NI square upon NN. Okay? Then the hole concentration will be equal to NI square upon NN when the electron concentration is far greater than that. Okay, let's take a B example. When ND minus NA is comparable to NI. Okay, ND minus NA is comparable to NI. You have to follow the same process as we followed in the when we discussed the derivation before. So okay, for N-type composite, ND comparable to NI. So using the law of electrical neutrality, ND plus P is equal to NA plus NN. Since it is an N-type semiconductor, NA is also there. We cannot neglect NA and we cannot make it zero. So this for N-type composite semiconductor. So we can say that ND is equal to NI square upon NN is equal to NA plus NN. Okay, so we get then ND NN plus NI square is equal to NN into NA plus NN. Okay, so on solving this thing and forming the quadratic equation, we get the concentration of electrons as ND minus NA by 2 plus square root of ND minus NA by 2 whole square plus NI square. Okay, this is important. And whole concentration will then become NI square by NN. This is when ND minus NA is comparable to NI. Okay, now similarly for the case 2, for a p-type compensated semiconductor, that is when NA is greater than ND, when case 1, when NA minus ND is far greater than NI, then we can approximate PP as NA minus ND. PP is equal to NA minus ND, and electron concentration will be NI square by PP. This is NI square upon Na minus Nd. Okay, second case, when Na minus Nd is comparable to Ni, so following the same taking the help of the same electrical neutrality equation, which is Nd plus Pp is equal to Na plus Np, we get the expression for Pp as Na minus Nd by 2 plus square root of Na minus Nd by 2 whole square plus Ni square. Understood? This will be the expression. And concentration of electrons will be equal to Ni square by Pp. Okay, this is very important theory. You should remember these expressions. Okay, you should embed these expressions into your mind, into your brain. Okay, now quickly move on to the next topic of discussion. We will have we will basically solve some examples related to these concepts in the next lecture. Let me complete critical wavelength. Let me discuss this with you. Critical wavelength, lambda c. Okay, so what is critical wavelength? Critical wavelength is also referred to as the maximum wavelength of the light, also called as maximum wavelength of light. Maximum wavelength of light, we represent lambda c as 1.24 by eg, and this is in micrometer. Understood? Lambda c is 1.24 by eg micrometer. Okay, Eg is the energy band gap, of the semiconductor in electron volts. Eg is in electron volts. Okay, and this is applicable for silicon and germanium and any type of semiconductor. Okay, so the wavelength of the visible light, we know lambda range of visible light is 0.38 micrometer to 0.76 micrometer. For the wavelengths greater than 0.76 micrometer, belongs to that region, belongs to the infrared region. Okay, for lambda greater than 0.76 micrometer, region is infrared region. Okay, so this is the theory covered. So that's all, folks. I'm ending this lecture here. We will talk about we'll solve some of the examples related to these concepts in the next lecture. Till then, this lecture is very much important. You should know these concepts very well. You should be well versed with the concept that I just told you in this lecture. Okay, thank you.